Let's jump into Dashmaster 2K and see how you can get the most out of it for your workspace, studio, or live production environment. As you can see, Dashmaster 2K is a super simple way to display multiple things at once on a single monitor. You can use it to keep track of multiple video sources like this YouTube video and Vimeo. You can keep track of the time. You can use it just to fill some monitors if you want to put something cool on there, or even something useful like HTTP buttons as well. Before we launch in, I just want to let you know that this is a product that I am personally making along with my buddy Lucas from StageTimer.io. So I want you to know that we're behind this, working hard on it, and also it's our project. So I'm over here on Dashmaster2k.com, and you can see I can get going by creating a dashboard right away, or I can browse this page. I'll let you do that in your own time. If I create a dashboard, it throws me into a demo dashboard here. And what we've set up is a YouTube live stream module. We also have a time of day module and just a little introduction so you know more about the product. I can instantly change how this looks, so I can jump into a 4-up instead. And now I have an extra little panel here that I can put in my own content. I can click on add here and see all of the currently available modules as well. So for example, you can browse through these and see video sources. You can see things like H2R graphics, StageTimer.io, but you can also put in some interesting content like this satellite map, line chart, or maybe even a QR code or a Google Doc or Sheet. For my use case, I want to add two things, a Twitch video source and a Twitch live chat as well. Here I have the Dash Ducks Twitch stream that I want to use, and good timing there. I'm going to copy the name of that from the URL, and then I want to choose a side-by-side layout. I'm going to edit my left one to be a Twitch stream, so I'm going to choose a channel, and then just paste in the channel name, hit save on that, and you'll see the Twitch video pop up. And then additionally, I'll just change this one on the right to a Twitch chat. Paste in the name, and now I have side-by-side chat and the live stream as well. Pretty nice. I could take the link to this dashboard and send it to anyone I know, and they could take a look at it. And since I'm not actually signed in here, they could actually edit it as well. But we can create an account and fix that real quickly. All right, so I'm back in Dashmaster 2K, and I'm logged in now as well. I have all my dashboards here, some seriously random ones. But I'm just going to paste in the link to the dashboard I just created. And you'll see in a second that I now have my little profile icon down in the corner. And I also have this option to claim this screen as my own. So I can click on that. And now this is part of my dashboards. In fact, if I just head back, you can see this one here. I'll just call it Demo Ducks. Perfect. So that is now my dashboard. I own it. And if anyone else opens that link, they can't edit it. They can just view it. Any changes I make on my dashboard here will be automatically updated on the viewer side as well. So if I remove a module or add a new one, they'll see that. Or if I change the layouts, they'll see that as well. We can take this another step further with Dashmaster 2K devices. So I'm back in my account and I'm in the My Devices section. And each of these devices below can be opened on a computer or a Raspberry Pi. And then I can send whatever dashboard I want to that device. Each device has an ID, it has an identify button, a URL, and then an option to send a dashboard to that device. I've cracked out my Raspberry Pis. I do have this one on the desk unconnected, but I have one connected to my video system, and we can take a look at that. I've booted up my Raspberry Pi here, and I can use the internet Chromium web browser to navigate to the device URL. The URL for the device that I want to use is app.dashmaster2k.com/d for device, and then the ID of that device. So let's just type that in here, and you can see I've already started app.dashmaster2k.com/d/SN7RXAAO. I can go to that URL, and when it loads up, it will load into my dashboard. I can use function F11 on the Raspberry Pi to go full screen, hide my mouse out of the way, and now I don't have to touch the Raspberry Pi anymore. I can go back to my other computer and do everything from there. I'm back on my Mac here, and I can see that my device has that URL. This is the one I want to manipulate, and I can choose what dashboard is going to that device. Now I have loads in my account here, but I'm just going to choose this one right here about the John screen. Why not? I'll click on that one. And if I go back over to my Raspberry Pi, you can see that it instantly updated and is now changed to a different dashboard. In fact, if in the background here, I just put it back to that previous one, you can see it does its thing. It goes off, checks what layout it should have, what modules it should use, and then fills in all that content. And you can see on the Pi here, it is a little bit slower than your average computer, but eventually the content will find its way in there. If you have multiple Dashmaster 2K devices set up, you might get a little bit lost on which device is which, and that's why we added that identify button. Over here, you can click on the show me, and if I click that and then show you my device, you'll see a little notice pops up saying, this is the device you mean. Let me click that again, and you can see it there. If you have a monitor wall full of these devices, you can click on the identify button and then instantly see which one you're going to change. We've already explored loads of features, but I do want to add a few extra ones that are just for paid Dashmaster 2K subscribers, so let's take a look at those. The first one to mention is even more layouts and custom layouts as well. So if I click on this extra layouts button at the bottom, you can see I have a lot more options in here. Maybe I want to do three tall ones, three long ones. I want to do a huge grid of lots of layouts, or even cooler, I can customize my own layout. So let's just click on that and I can see this little diagram here where I can draw in my own custom layout. So for example, maybe I want to add a random video there. I want to add the time of day here. Maybe I want a nice little QR code that shows up down here. And then I'll fill the rest with a couple more boxes like this, just for demos. When I hit done, you can see that I have that layout on my dashboard. And now I can go through and set each of the modules. So I want to put a time of day up there. I said I would put a QR code down here. So I can just go to Dashmaster 2K as the QR code, works nicely. Maybe I can set this one up to be text and image. Here is some text. And I could set this one up to be a YouTube video, for example, or whatever else I want to put in there in my custom layout. And I can always go back in, change that custom layout, delete a box, add a few more that look a bit different if I want to, hit save on that, and then I've got that new custom layout working nicely. We've also added a pro option to clean up your dashboard even more and focus on the content. Down in the bottom corner here, I have this hide button. And when I click on that, you can see that the Dashmaster header and footer disappears. And now this app in full screen mode looks even cleaner. And all I see is the content on my dashboard. So that's a quick look at making dashboards and using devices in Dashmaster 2K. Do let us know if you have any issues, or you can head over to our new documentation section here. Check out how to get started and some guides on the modules that we support currently, or you can always send us an email with ideas for modules that you'd like to see in Dashmaster 2K. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.